In this session, I'll be discussing about mushroom poisoning and its molecular mechanism. Objectives of the session are, at the end of the session, the learner shall be able to describe basis of mushroom poisoning and molecular mechanism of mushroom poisoning, consequences of mushroom poisoning. Okay, let us discuss one by one. So the food items made by the mushroom are reputed to be delicious. Okay, but some wild mushrooms, they are colloquially called as death cap, okay, or destroying angel. One of that wild mushroom is Amanita pallidus. It is known as the Amanita pallidus. This is one type of wild mushroom which is a toxic. Okay, the consumption of this particular mushroom leads to the death. So why this Amanita pallidus is toxic? It contains toxic substances. Such wild mushrooms contains toxic substances, so including many amatoxins. So this amatoxin is a bicyclic octapeptide. So this is amatoxin. One of the amatoxin is alpha amanitin. This is lethal. This particular amanitin is lethal. So when this Amanita pallidus, consumption of this wild mushroom, so leads to several deaths. How the toxicity of Amanita toxin leads to deaths. Okay. So then the next objective is the molecular mechanism. It can be explained because the action is at the molecular levels. In the molecular levels, it inhibits one group of enzymes. It inhibits, eukaryotic. It is not toxic to the prokaryotes. So it is toxic to the eukaryotic system. Eukaryotic RNA polymerase. What is the function of RNA polymerase? RNA polymerase is required in the transcription process. In the eukaryotic system, there are three types of RNA polymerase are there. That is one, the second one, and third one. One is responsible for the ribosomal RNA synthesis. The second one is messenger RNA synthesis. Okay, then the third one is the transfer RNA synthesis and 5S, ribosomal RNA and also small nuclear RNA. Okay, so these three RNAs are there, RNA polymerases are there. Will it affect all the RNA polymerases? No. Okay, so let us see how it is going to affect this particular polymerase. Let us see here. Okay, then here it is. This is measure 1. So this is inhibited by alpha amanitin. This inhibits inhibited by alpha amanitin. Okay, inhibition by this particular toxic alpha amanitin. This alpha amanitin also can inhibit RNA polymerase 3. But not the RNA polymerase 1. So majorly it is affecting RNA polymerase 2, and at higher concentration it is affecting RNA polymerase 3, not the RNA polymerase 1. Okay, then let us see. When you talk about the inhibition, when you compare, the level of inhibition, the inhibition on RNA polymerase, RNAP, 2 is much more than Okay, RNA polymerase 3. So then how it can be, or why it is so? Because when you talk about alpha amanitin, will be inhibiting, of course, both the enzymes. But so the level of the inhibition is a different. Okay, here it is, tighter complex forms with the RNA polymerase 2. Here it is looser complex. So that is the reason the severity is less in case of RNA polymerase 3. Okay, that means at low concentration, so it will have the very high effect. Whereas to find some effect of inhibition on 3, it is high concentration. At high concentration, so it inhibits 3. Okay, then let us see, there are some questions are there. That means, can it inhibit, okay, other enzymes like telomerase? Okay, no. Okay, that is a big no. Then, can it inhibit DNA polymerase? No. Again, it is a no. Okay, can it inhibit prokaryotic RNA polymerase? No. Even this, the toxin will not inhibit the RNA polymerase of Amanita pallidus. Also, it doesn't inhibit, RNA polymerase 1. It is resistant to this toxin. RNAP1 is resistant to this amanitin. Okay, consumption of Amanita pallidus from their alpha amanitin, it is inhibiting the process of transcription. Let us see, RNAP2. This RNAP2 by the alpha amanitin, inhibition of transcription process, eukaryotic transcription, not the prokaryotic transcription, that has to be noted. Okay, then it lowers the synthesis of messenger RNA, and most of the time it decreases the synthesis of messenger RNA or no messenger RNA. What is the ultimate effect? No messenger RNA. Then ultimately what will happen? No protein synthesis. Okay, because for the protein synthesis, messenger RNA is required. Okay, the information present on messenger RNA is required for the protein synthesis. Okay, what is the concentration at which it is toxic? Okay, concentration, does it require very high amount to inhibit this process? At which this amanitin is toxic. It is toxic at very, very low level. It is deadly even at 10 to the 4 of minus 8 molar concentration. So when you take the 40 grams of fresh mushrooms, from there this toxin will be around 4 to 6 milligrams of toxin. Okay, this is sufficient to kill. Sufficient to kill, human adult. Okay, at this low concentration also, it can kill human adult. That is the reason it is called death cap and or destroying angel. What are the consequences? The third objective, consequences of alpha amanitin. The consumption of amanitin toxin, which it is present in Amanita pallidus, causes slow death slow, okay, death. Okay, so the poisoning is twofold. It is twofold poisoning. The one is mild initial. So they are relatively mild, and so there are the manifestations like gastrointestinal, okay, disturbances. Okay, that is the one aspect. Second, then, okay, electrolyte imbalance, it creates electrolyte imbalance. Then, next, followed by, so liver and kidney dysfunction, liver and kidney dysfunction. So the parenchymal, the tissue there, it is damaged. Okay, then, so death will be immediate? No, death can follow usually no earlier than, okay, then several days. So that is the reason we said slow death. Why slow death? Because in the eukaryotic system, okay, the transcription is the slow transcription rate comparison to the prokaryotic system, also low turnover of the proteins. That is the reason it takes that much time. Okay, so several days, maybe 7, 8, 5, like that. Okay, then is there any therapy? Okay, is there any therapy? Actually, when you talk about this one, there is only support to, okay, therapy, including liver transplantation. Okay, so transplantation, there is support to therapy, including liver transplantation. Efficacy, is it proved efficacy? Okay, so efficacy is unproven. Okay, let me summarize. In this session, we have discussed about the mushroom poisoning and explained through the molecular mechanism. Okay, then, so objectives of this session are, at the end of the session, the learner shall be able to describe basis of mushroom poisoning, molecular mechanism of mushroom poisoning, and consequences of mushroom poisoning. Food items made by the mushrooms are reputed to be delicious. Okay, but some wild mushrooms, if they are contaminated with those good mushrooms, so they can lead to the severe consequences, including death. That is the reason it is called death cap or destroying angel. So one of such mushroom is Amanita pallidus. It is toxic. See, it contains the toxic substances, hematotoxins. They are the bicyclic octapeptides. And one is alpha amanitin, which is lethal. The consumption of this particular wild mushroom leads to several deaths. Okay, so molecular mechanism. What is the second objective? Is molecular mechanism inhibits eukaryotic RNA polymerase, not the prokaryotic system. Okay, eukaryotic RNA polymerase, the three RNA polymerases are there, 1, 2, and 3. So, one is for the synthesis of ribosomal RNA, 2 is the synthesis of messenger RNA, 3 is the synthesis of transfer RNA, 5S ribosomal RNA, small nuclear RNA. So, the 2 is inhibited. So, by the alpha amanitin, maximum effect on the 2, then followed by the 3. There is no effect on RNA polymerase 1. Okay, then inhibition, when you compare with the 2 and 3, it is much more on RNAP2 compared to the 3. Okay, then why? Alpha amanitin can have the titer complex With the RNAP2, even at the low concentration, it is highly toxic, whereas inhibition is much more, and whereas in the three, lows are complex, so higher concentration is required. Okay, then, can it inhibit telomerase? No. Okay, then, can it inhibit DNA polymerase? No. Can it inhibit prokaryotic RNA polymerase? No. So, the RNAP, RNA polymerase 1 is resistant to the action by the amanitin. RNAP2, in the presence of alpha-amanitin, inhibition of the transcription is taking place. Either, in this case, either there is very low messenger RNA synthesis or there is no messenger RNA. If there is no messenger RNA, there is no question of protein synthesis. So, what is the concentration at which it is toxic? It is deadly even at 10 to the 4 of minus 8 molar concentration. Okay, 40 grams of fresh mushrooms. So, when you extract it, so there are 4 to 6 milligrams of toxin is there. This is sufficient to kill human adult. Okay, this is how that much it is toxic. Okay, then next objective is, the next consequences, alpha-amanitin. So, okay, causes slow death. It is twofold, that is initial and then later the severe the manifestations. Initially, relatively mild, okay, gastrointestinal disturbances, then electrolyte imbalances, followed by the, okay, liver and kidney failure, dysfunction, okay. Death can follow usually no earlier than several days, okay. There may be 5 to 9 days, okay. Then, so is there any, why slow death? Because the rate of the eukaryotic transcription is much slow comparison to the prokaryotic transcription. And also, protein turnover is also low. Okay, is there any therapy? Okay, only support two is there. There is an option of including, that is liver transplantation. But is the efficacy is proven? No, it is. Efficacy has not been proven. It is unproven. Thank you. Thank you very much.